Welcome back to the 2 Minute Warning for episode 419. Today we're looking at the Miami Dolphins and what to expect from them in 2021, such as the NFL draft, the season in general, free agency, so on and so forth. But before getting into that topic, question for those of you viewing, especially you Miami Dolphins fans. Dan Marino led the Miami Dolphins to one Super Bowl appearance. Unfortunately, they lost, but who was the team that they lost to? If you know the answer, comment it down below. If you do not, I will reveal the answer at the end, so make sure you stay tuned. But looking at the Miami Dolphins this past season, finishing 10-6, pretty successful season. However, they missed the playoffs, pretty unfortunate. 9 times out of 10, in my opinion, if you go 10-6, you're more than likely going to get at least a wild card spot in the NFL playoffs, especially with the playoffs adding on an extra 7th seed now. I was very surprised to see the Dolphins miss it, but it is what it is. Next year, I don't want to say it's like playoffs or you didn't succeed, but you kind of do all have the right pieces in the Miami Dolphins right now, and the little bits of gaps that you do have are definitely fixable in one NFL offseason. Now, of course, a lot of this can change pending what the Miami Dolphins do. If they trade for Deshaun Watson, if they decide to draft a quarterback in the first round of Zach Wilson, Justin Fields, or if they stick with Tua Tagovailoa, obviously that will alternate this exact prediction and assumption. But looking at them right now, like I said, 10-6, top 5 defense, pretty well coached, or pretty good coach in Brian Flores. He's coaching very well lately. One of those coaches to come off of the Bill Belichick coaching tree and actually perform well. We've seen most guys don't actually do too hot, such as Matt Patricia in Detroit. However, Brian Flores in Miami is doing a great job. Offense, that is probably the biggest issue. As you guys know, there's a lot of speculation around Tua Tagovailoa. I think there's a lot of assumption that they might actually draft a quarterback with the number 3 overall pick in the NFL draft, such as Zach Wilson. But to me, I am not a fan of Tua Tagovailoa in the long run, 10, 15 years from now, but I do think it is way too early to bail out on him right now. Now, if Deshaun Watson's available, I'm the Miami Dolphins, I'm definitely trading for him. Looking at the situation right now, at number 3 overall, I'd much rather give Tua Tagovailoa the top offensive tackle and top protector coming into the NFL, such as Penei Sewell or even Rashawn Slater, to give him protection in the pocket rather than just replacing him right away. I understand the logic behind possibly drafting Zach Wilson, but I just think it's too soon to bail on Tua Tagovailoa just yet. So he's only played about half a season. I say give him a little more time. And as much as you want to say he's not the greatest quarterback, he's not the most athletic quarterback, he doesn't have an it factor to him, he has a lot of issues, you could say. He won football games with the Miami Dolphins, and you really can't argue against that at the end of the day. That is kind of what matters most, and Tua Tagovailoa wins football games. So I think you need to just invest in him more, give him an offensive weapon, and give him a bit more protection. And this Miami Dolphins team can really go to the playoffs and do some damage, in my opinion. I think this offseason they should, in free agency, maybe entertain the idea of Allen Robinson, entertain the idea of Aaron Jones, one of the top free agent running backs from the Green Bay Packers. Allen Robinson, like I just said, from Chicago. Maybe Corey Davis from the Tennessee Titans. Maybe Chris Godwin from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Or you have the number 18th overall pick in the NFL draft as well. You got 2 first rounders. I say go protection at number 3 overall, such as Penei Sewell or Rashawn Slater, whichever one is not available. And then at number 18 overall, you pick up a receiver. You get lucky that Jaylen Waddle fell really low, or you get Kadarius Toney from Florida Gators. There's a lot of options out there that can upgrade this receiving core. There is some talent in the receiving core already in Devontae Parker, like very underrated wide out in my opinion, and a good safety blanket tight end, and Mike Gesicki. A couple other receivers that are at least worth mentioning, but not the greatest, but Jakeem Grant, really speedy guy in the Dolphins. Albert Wilson, Preston Williams, Alan Hearns is on that team as well. So a lot of those guys, they're not all-star receivers by any means, but they're notable names and they can catch the football. So there is some talent, not a lot of depth and not a lot of huge stardom on the receiving core, but Tua Tagovailoa is not working with nothing. Doesn't need a whole new receiving core. I just think it needs one more X factor that can easily be fixed in free agency or the NFL draft. Now, the top 5 defense that I talked about in the Miami Dolphins, which is incredibly led by Xavien Howard, who led in interceptions last year, 9 interceptions, decided to release pretty much their captain linebacker, Kyle Van Noy. Saved them $10 million in cap space, but to me, unless they're going for a huge trade, I really don't understand the move there in their star linebacker. He was, like I said, captain of the defense outside of Xavien Howard for the most part, really led that front 7. A lot of guys looked up to him, and he performed well. He didn't do anything wrong, so I am confused what they did that for. But if it was in order to free up cap space to trade for Deshaun Watson, I get that there. But if they're sticking with Tua, I'm not a huge fan of that move. But clearly there's something in the front office that they know that I don't know. So I'm assuming there is some logic behind it for sure. Overall, I think in this free agency and NFL draft offseason, all they need to do is get Tua one extra tackle and one extra receiver, and this team is ready for the playoffs. I don't think they'll go 12-4, 13-3, 14-2, but I do see them sitting around 10-6 and 11-5 again. And I think there's no way in my mind if they go 10-6 or 11-5 that they're out of the playoffs again. Now, if they go in the playoffs first round and they got to play Patrick Mahomes and Kansas City Chiefs right away, going to Kansas City, I would guess that they're going to have a first round exit. But to be honest, this Miami team is good enough to fight for the division. I don't know if they can't. They will take down Josh Allen, but they 100% have the capability to do so. I think if Tua steps up and it's just even a little bit better than we all think, his team could carry him to going toe-to-toe with Josh Allen and the Buffalo Bills, and I'd like to see him do it. So to me, you get Penei Sewell, you get Jalen Waddle, or whatever you want to do at number three overall, maybe Kyle Pitts. I know you have Mike Gesicki, but Kyle Pitts is one of the best prospects in the NFL right now. I say maybe go for Kyle Pitts, and then instead of drafting Penei Sewell, get Terrell Williams, a left tackle from the 49ers in free agency, and just protect this quarterback, maybe upgrade a running back. Really, like I said, this team has some holes, but even with the current roster, they went 10-6. So to me, even if you just fix a couple pieces, this is a possible 11-5 division-winning team that I think could do some damage in the playoffs. So I do have high hopes for the Miami Dolphins, and if I had to put money on it, I do think they make the playoffs next year. Like I said, a well-coached, great defense, and the offense can definitely be fixed up. I think they could go far. They're going to get a new offensive coordinator, and I really do have them going to the playoffs and maybe getting one playoff win or so. Not going to bet on them to go super far to the AFC Championship or Super Bowl, just because I don't know exactly what all is in Tua Tagovailoa. But as of right now, I do think he's a quarterback that can at least get them there in the playoffs to stand a fighter's chance. Because, like I always say, while you might be the underdog in the playoffs, if you're there, you have a chance, or else you wouldn't be there. So if Tua could get them that far, of course they have a fighter's chance to go all the way. And in my assumption, I think they could get a playoff berth and maybe one playoff win. But I don't see an AFC championship in their future by any means. But all in all, a lot of it is going to determine how much the Miami Dolphins front office executes in this offseason. Are they going to get them protection? Are they going to get them an extra star in his receiving core? Are they going to be able to, you know, either replace Kyle Van Noy or show the reasoning they dropped him because it was a trade or so on and so forth? Maybe Myles Gaskin in the backfield is viable, but look at second round draft picks in the second round of the NFL draft. Look at Najee Harris or Trey Sermon or Travis Etienne, or even late in the first round. Upgrade this offense as much as you can. Surround Tua Tagovailoa with the fortress of an offense like the Cleveland Browns do with Baker Mayfield, and I definitely think this team can go to the playoffs and get a playoff win. But anything could change. Like I said, a lot of it is going to determine what they do this offseason. For all I know, Tua Tagovailoa might not even be the starting quarterback next year, so there's a lot of speculation, but those are just my thoughts. Hope you guys agree. Let me know, though. Do you think the Dolphins will go to the playoffs? Do you think the Dolphins will stick with Tua Tagovailoa? Do you think they can even go to the Super Bowl? So on and so forth. Like I said, let me know below in the comments. That is all I got. But for the question of the day, those of you viewing, the Dan Marino led the Miami Dolphins to the Super Bowl one time, and the one team he lost to was in a blowout loss to the San Francisco 49ers. I think Dan Marino is probably the best player to never win a Super Bowl ring, but let me know what you guys think. 2-1.